settle into prayer or meditation, just settle in this morning. Let this be our prayer this morning, that we may be able to hold the beauty of this world right next to the suffering that so many experience. That the beauty of voice and instrument here not be an escape from the world, the country, the community, the reality that we live in, but rather that this music be an expression of this reality. May we watch the moments this week when we have let others down. May we have hearts big enough to notice the grace we have received, the kindness we have been shown, the beauty that is all around us and here as well. Let this be our prayer this morning, that all that is created often comes out of the in-between of joy and suffering, that this is what it means to be alive, that we are here holding hearts that are heavy, hearts that are celebrating, hearts growing weary with concern, and hearts bursting to share with one another. Let this be our prayer this morning. In the silence, in the stillness, we hold all of this together as we do each week. In the silence and in the stillness, we just let it be. So let us join in that silence together. This morning is hymn number 396 in your grave hymnals. We know this rose will open. We will sing it once through together, and then we will sing it in a two-part round, so down the center aisle.
What I have in mind for this music Sunday. You'll notice that there are words for all the choral pieces in your order of service. And that's because I think the words are a really integral part of this music Sunday, and that I think it tells the story of community. We start with the Ubi Caritas, where charity and love are, God is there. So as we come together every Sunday morning, we're a member of this community of charity and love. bridge over troubled water. As we go out into the world, we experience the world and we experience the problems that come with the world. And as it says, I'm on your side when times get rough, and friends just can't be found. Like a bridge over water, I will lay me down. And then for a vision unfolding, it's about us going into the world and really building this vision that we have together. Talking about a vision unfolding a dream to reach empathy. A vision's unfolding a dream, grace within our reach. A vision's unfolding a dream, woven harmony. A vision's unfolding a dream, focused energy. And I think that's really what we are about when we come to the world. And finally, the road home. When we come back to each other, we always have this community to return to. As it says, tell me where is the road I can call my own, that I left, that I lost so long ago. Rise up, follow me, come away is the call. With love in your heart as the only song, there is no such beauty as where you belong. Rise up.
I don't think I've ever felt as humbled as I do right now to get up here. That was so beautiful. Thank you. Ms. Brack and I were away in Colorado for a musicians network conference this summer. We heard this piece together while we were sitting in a room, and Brack turned to me and he said, "That's the piece." I was like, "Are you sure?" And Brack was like, "Yeah, I'm sure." Let this be a message to us all about trusting, right? I have to share with you all that more than once this week, I have been prone to an insidious thought. How can we be enjoying all this beauty on a Sunday morning when our country and our world are in crisis all around us? These songs, these choral arrangements are such a gift. How can we hold both beauty and delight alongside the suffering and the anxiety of our neighbors and ourselves? And I have to name this thought as insidious, because it comes from a fearful sense of scarcity, from a place that believes we should only be focused on what's wrong in our world and in need of fixing, or from a place that believes that human capacity is limited and should be brought to one thing or the other, beauty or tragedy, delight or disaster. What does the song say about when you're weary and feeling small, right? Yesterday, I attended an art-making party right here in this church. We gathered on the third floor with snacks and a whole pile of art supplies in the RE room, and it was as if adults had just come together in a spirit of creativity and joy and laughter to create visual art, to paint, to glue, to cut. There was laughter, sharing life stories, appreciation of what others are making, and time to offer help to one another. Out of the messiness of creativity comes community, comes healing, comes the peace we need to see, or the note we needed to hear, or the words sung that spoke to our hearts. Each Sunday morning when we hear a piece from our choir, I am filled with appreciation for the beauty in this place, and I imagine that you are too. But those of us who are here to listen and to witness these beautiful pieces don't often see are the hours and moments of rehearsal time that go into these pieces. The moments of sitting next to one another, catching up before choir practice, the humming or singing in the car on the way to church or on the way home, the warming up of voices that leads to finding harmonies. The OJs remind us that music is the healing force of the world. And perhaps, even as all is going wrong in our world, And we sit with deep anxiety about an unsure future. What we need most is some time to enjoy the beauty around us. Yes. Yes. Perhaps what we need this morning are moments to appreciate the healing message that music is bringing to our spirits. Perhaps what we need is to appreciate that this gorgeous music came out of a messy process. Out of the starts and stops of singing it this way or enunciating a word that way. To be reminded that we are in a messy time, not knowing what will come of it. But given this tender reminder this morning that even in the mess there is still beauty. Even in the mess there is still beauty. This is one of the paradoxes of being human. It's a part of what we are asked to hold each day. We live in a space of both beauty and deep difficulty. In this vision unfolding, the future seems uncertain. But in the present moment, we are invited to just sit in it. Just sit in it and enjoy these gifts. To receive them with gratitude. To honor the many people who have gathered here year after year, decade after decade, to celebrate and appreciate the healing power of music. May you find a healing word in the notes this morning. May your hearts know their strength in holding both tragedy and the gifts of the Spirit. May you find some sense of beauty and connection emerging out of the messiness. Let us remember this morning that this is what we are made for. Amen. Blessed be. And may it be so.